I'm a single mom, and my son is in first grade. We just moved to Grand Prairie, so he's going to a new, different school than he did for kindergarten. The problem, or not problem, I have is that I think I have a crush on his teacher. He's single, handsome, and around my age. Is it a bad idea to get involved or even approach my kid's teacher? Do teachers think that this is inappropriate? What are their negative effects for my son? Should I wait? I mean, that's like 9 months. Do I want to wait that long? Dating has been hard enough, so I was hoping y'all could help me, and so I can either go for it or put my energy elsewhere. Interesting question.
My first question is, and I don't know the answer to it, but I would assume that there's some kind of rule that you're not allowed to be dating your kid's parents.
I don't know. Is there? That's a good question.
I don't know. That's a good question to ask. I don't know, but I would assume there's probably some kind of a school rule, and that's why we really want to hear from teachers. Is it an unwritten rule?
Yeah.
Or is it something that's actually in the handbook for teachers in schools?
It's a really good question. And does it matter, like, for her son's in first grade, does it matter the age of the kid, too? Like, is it something that teachers feel more comfortable when they're younger because maybe they might not be as aware, as opposed to if the kid's, like, in junior high and, like, yeah, your mom's dating the teacher? Or,
I think, to me, younger would be worse.
You think so?
I'm big into early childhood development. Yeah. You shouldn't be, like, you got to be careful who you're dating around your kid.
You know,
and introducing kids to girlfriends and boyfriends and stuff like that.
You could also do it, you know, a little more secretly if the kid's younger, I guess was my point too. Not necessarily involving them. But do you also think it matters? Does the kid like his teacher? Mr. Jim over here, this guy gave me unsatisfactory on my spelling test. You're not dating him, Mom. Let's see, Carissa. Good morning. Carissa's in North Dallas. You're a teacher, right?
Good morning. Yes, I am a teacher.
All right. So is this appropriate? Is this inappropriate for her to go ahead and maybe make a move?
Well, I think it's very nice that she's being cautious about it and thinking it through. I don't know if it's technically a district policy, but I don't think it's something that's smiled upon for teachers to get in a professional relationship with parents, especially current parents that they have. And, you know, especially if he's a young teacher, that's just, I mean, putting his, you know, profession on the line.
Good point.
Especially if something didn't happen right with the relationship, then he has to carry out the rest of the year with this student and this family.
Great point, too.
Great point. Thank you so much, Chris. You have a great day today, okay?
Thanks.
Thank you. That's a really, really good point. Erica's in Plano. Good morning, Erica.
Good morning.
Now, you're a high school teacher, so you got a little bit older kids than this first grader. So do you think this is inappropriate for her to go ahead and say, hey, this guy's really nice. I have a hard time dating. What should I do?
Yeah, I'm going to agree with the last caller. It's correct. Not a good idea no matter what age you're at. And I'm single, so I understand it's hard. But I've had my students, on the other hand, want to set me up with their parents or their uncles.
That's funny.
And I have to be like, no, that's so not appropriate on, like, any level.
So is it ever appropriate? Like, so we were starting to think of, okay, wait, if we wait until the end of the school year, is it ever appropriate if you've ever had this kid in your classroom?
You know, that's one of those, like, gray areas.
Yeah.
So to me, if she thinks he's that good looking and she wants to go for it, I would wait until even the school year. I would wait till your kid's like, it's been even a couple of years.
Can she drop some hints along the way so he doesn't get all, he doesn't get all wifed up in the meantime?
You know, if that's what happens, that's what happens. And it just wasn't meant to be.
I get if this guy looks like Ryan Gosling, how difficult that may be. But I'm starting to think that it may never be appropriate, because if you ever had this kid in your class, all of a sudden that kid's in, like, you know, the kid goes to second grade, people start asking questions. The kid still has to live with that kid that's still in that school. So I don't think it's ever really appropriate if you've ever.
Ever is to the extreme, too, because you never know. Maybe what if 2 years down there, 3 years down the road, you know, all of a sudden they meet up again and maybe the kid's not even in that school anymore.
He's still in the school. Yeah.
Sarah's in Frisco. Good morning. You're also a high school teacher, right, Sarah?
Yes, I am.
All right, Sarah. So is this appropriate for her to go ahead and say, hey, this guy's really nice. Maybe I should pursue this.
Well, I don't think it's necessarily inappropriate, but like everyone said, I think it makes it harder to kind of do your job as a teacher when you're like trying to build a relationship with their student. But honestly, my advice would be, one, wait till the end of the year. You know, volunteer and do things if you want to get to know the classroom and, you know, be there. But don't do anything because, you know, like you said, you're with that student all year. It's not like, you know, your child's doctor and you can go find another doctor. Like, you're stuck for a whole year with that particular teacher. But honestly, it's one of those things. It's like, if you see him out, you know, and he initiates it, cool, you know, go with it with caution. But I don't say it never could happen, but just, you know, wait a little bit longer, wait for your child to get used to their teacher. And then if you do start dating, you know, put up a lot of boundaries. That way there is no, like, major conflict.
Do you think it's worse for the parent, the teacher, or the kid in this situation if they start dating?
Honestly, I think it's how you handle it. I think it can be really, really bad for the student. I mean, depending, you know, on the age, I think younger, they're going to just see it as, I'm going to, like, tell my friends what I see. So they probably definitely go to school and be like, hey, my teacher was at my house last night. And then, of course, that's going to be really, really bad.
Yeah. I think that's where the boundaries come in you were talking about. You really have to set those.
As a teacher, I mean, that's a little difficult for me because I'm already, like, really cautious being a high school teacher with my kids. Like, you know, you're not on my social media. You don't get to know my personal life. So kind of breaking that barrier down where if I dated some students, like, dad, it'd be weird for me because I'd be like, I'm trying not to get to know you in that sense. And now you're getting to see me in, like, multiple settings. Like, no, that's just weird.
Real question though, Sarah, and I'm being completely honest. Is it different for hooking up? Can you just hook up with a parent
and
one time?
And not tell anybody?
And not tell anyone?
I mean, I feel like that would still be weird. Like, if I knew that was someone's dad, like, I'd feel really weird about it.
Sure.
So personally,
you feel weird. Yeah. Different, but I think
it's different than dating,
weird,
right?
Like, yeah, like this hidden secret going to class every day, like, oh my gosh, like I just slept with your dad. Like, Sarah, that would be horrible.
That sounds like a porno, too.
Correct me if I'm wrong. If a tree falls in a forest and no one's hears it, does it really fall, right? Kind of situation.
I mean, for me, it probably would still fall.
Right, okay.